In Chapter 16, we'll be covering specific ways you can factor trinomials. As you may recall from previous sections, factoring is not necessarily the most obvious thing in the world, and so there have been some methods that have been developed to make that process a lot easier. If we were to look at a generic trinomial like a squared plus 2ab plus b squared, we know that it's easy to factor that to a plus b squared. If you don't believe me, you can always FOIL that out and see if it really does come out to that, but I promise you it does. To take a trinomial like this generic trinomial, it happens to be a perfect square, but we have to figure out what C actually represents. If we want to make a perfect square given two terms but an unknown third term, we can find C by taking 1/2 and multiplying that to b and squaring it. So if we look at example 1, we notice that b is represented by the 10, just like it was a b in the example. So now if we want to find c, as it's requesting we do, we know that it's 1/2 b squared. So I'm going to take 10 and substitute it in for b. So I get 1/2 times 10, and technically it's over 1 since we're multiplying two fractions together, raised to the second power. Now we can multiply those straight across. 1 times 10 is 10, and 2 times 1 is 2 squared. Notice this reduces to 5 squared, and we know 5 squared is 25. So we can rewrite our trinomial with C now as an actual value. This factors nicely, since it's a perfect square trinomial, to x plus 5 squared. In example 2, we have to find c as well, so we know that c represents 1/2 multiplied to b squared, or 1/2 b squared. Substituting negative 7 in for b, we get 1/2 times negative 7 over 1 squared, which is equal to negative 7 over 2. Remember, we still have to square that to get 49, and that's positive over 4. So c represents 49 over 4, so we can rewrite our perfect square trinomial as x squared minus 7x plus 49/4. Since we now have our perfect square trinomial, it will factor beautifully to x plus a negative 7, so I should just write x minus 7/2 quantity squared. Notice that if your middle term is negative, then this is going to have to be negative if it's a perfect square trinomial. In example 3, again we need to find c. There's our formula for finding c, 1/2 times b squared. I'm going to substitute negative 3/7 in for b. And I'll put the negative on the top. It tends to be a little easier to figure out when it's on the top of the fraction. So I'm going to have negative 3 over 14 raised to the second power. This, when multiplied to itself, gives me negative times a negative gives me a positive 9 over 196. My perfect square trinomial, I can now write out completely, since I've found C to be 9/196. So when it factors to x minus 3/14 squared. In example 4, we again find C. Same formula, 1/2 b squared. Substituting 6/5 in for b, we get 1/2 times 6/5 squared. We can rewrite that as 6/10 squared. Notice 6/10 is reducible, so I'm going to reduce it, that fraction, before I square. So that's going to be 3/5 squared, which gives me 9/25. So now I take 9/25, put it in for C, and rewrite my perfect square trinomial. And then factoring, I get x plus 3/5 squared.